So I've come to a property today to do an EICR. As you can hear, it's probably a little bit echoey because they are renovating it, they're having it decorated, etc. So I just thought it was a good opportunity to get a video in based on the new update for BS7671. So Amendment 2 has now dropped, and there's a change to how we test our RCD. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to walk through what that change means to us and how it affects us and how we perform this test. So one of the changes in BS7671, as we said earlier, was how we test our RCD. So now they've added a little note that sort of states, regardless of which type of RCD we have, remember we're pushing towards type A's now, and BS7671 has started to update to that as well. Even if we have a type A, we can still test it with the type AC setting on our tester. And it also states that regardless of additional protection, fault protection, etc., we can deem effectiveness of the RCD by testing it at 1x its I delta N. So we have a 30 milliamp RCD here in this installation. So my I delta N is 30 milliamps. Okay, so now actually we're going to test it at 1x, and that is enough for us to deem it as effective. Okay, so all I'm going to do is I'm going to test the RCD here at source. Remember, this is a live test, so I do have GS38 probes, etc. Now that's disconnected in 28.6 milliseconds. I'm then going to re-energize the RCD, and I'm going to switch this to the other side of the cycle. And remember, I'm testing it at 1x its I delta M. And that is disconnected at 18.9 milliseconds. So with them disconnection times, it's also important to note that in the note in BS7671, it talks about when we test it at 1x its I delta N value for a non-delay type RCD, which is what we have here in the installation, that it must disconnect within 300 milliseconds. So according to BS7671 Amendment 2, we have now deemed this RCD as effective because we have tested it at 1x its I delta N. So we've tested it at 30 milliamps, and the result was less than 300 milliseconds. It's always important to remember though that BS7671 is the minimum requirement. So what I will do as part of this EICR is I will still go and test it at x5. The amendment hasn't dropped a long time ago, so you know it's going to take a while for people to get used to different methods, but I will still probably test it at x1 its value, x5, x1/2, and then we will use the test button to make sure the test button is effective. So again, just to recap, according to BS7671 Amendment 2, we now only have to test on the AC setting of our tester, regardless of the type of RCD. And also we only have to test it at x1 its I delta N. Its I delta N for this particular RCD being 30 milliamps, so we test it at 30 milliamps. And as long as it disconnects within 300 milliseconds, we can deem that as an effective RCD, okay? Remember, again, it is the minimum requirement for us as electricians to follow BS7671. So if you choose to still test it at x5, x1/2, etc., like I will, then that is entirely your judgment. I probably will still continue to do that, maybe from a force of habit and just going that little bit extra. Yeah, so I hope this video has been some help.